half the spots we have up there.
Now, can I go into the booth?
Thank you.
We should start.
I'll probably go find some drugs.
So hello everybody and welcome to our fifth annual Beckies, an end of the year showcase that's hosted, acted, managed, and selected by the students. So I'm Mr. Beck. I had the pleasure, most of the time, working with these talented students. So tonight's showcase is part Disneyfied Friar Club's roast, or like Comedy Central roast if you're more familiar with that. Part award show, but all student collaborated, and a showcase of their writing, their acting, their directing, their technical abilities, and general theatricality learned in four levels of theater classes. The program continues to provide a vehicle for novices and experienced alike, so you're going to see many different levels. Students who have never stepped on the stage prior to this, and some who have been on the stage for 4 years. So we have grown our curriculum over these last few years. We began this award show in 2017, and we've definitely grown a bit since then to include a 4-year adventure. Thanks in part to the support of Dr. Ennis Anso, Dr. Thompson, our staff, our administration, of this excellent district that supports the arts. There are many districts where they cut the arts. Here, they allowed this program to grow to include 4 years, a CTE, a certification that we're working on, and many different things that will provide these students theatrical abilities for the rest of their lives. This year, we brought a student-directed and designed children's show to the elementary school. So we just did Little Mermaid, our Theater 4 class, completely teched and directed and acted in that show. We also have created, through our Theater 4 program, community-driven events, such as Deck the Halls and a Safe Halloween that allows students to come here and trick-or-treat through various rooms and experiences. So all those things have definitely grown and made this program one of the strongest theater programs on Long Island. The students surprise me on the daily with their creativity, their humor, their theatricality. They also bully me on a daily basis. But you can ask my wife who's here, sometimes crying myself to sleep over what the business is. Just kidding. Or am I? In any case, here's one student who is so nice, you wouldn't think she'd have anything harsh to say. In that case, you'd be wrong. Here is Sarah Hughes to introduce Theater 1, Period 2.
I'm your host, Alexa, and this is
Theater 1, Period 2!
Us Mr. Beck secretly hates.
Man, Why is that?
I would enjoy the silence once in a while.
I can't argue with that. Considering half the time there's a presidential debate or an annoying Draco Malfoy fan drilling.
Don't forget the constant bickering over nonsense.
Speaking of pantomime, I gotta go. Don't worry, I'll be right back.
You can't just leave. Where did you go? Oh. Okay, hey folks. Anyways, we combine pantomime, which is acting without words, and theater superstitions, like not wearing blue on stage, avoiding lighting a trio of candles, or saying the Scottish play title. You know, Macbeth, Big Mac, whatever, you know the title. This one happens to be a dance.
We have
few things here.
Oh my god, I just met my idol.
When? Where?
Just now, it's Mr. President.
Joe Biden's here? Why?
No, why would he be here? I'm talking about Bobby. I aspire to be like him so much.
Bobby, why?
Because he's in a commercial.
Oh, like a baby commercial.
No. Like a presidential campaign commercial. Here's Abby, Bobby, Michelle, and... you. What? You're gonna be in his commercial?
So then, Mr. Beck, here's Bobby for president.
What the heck?
Don't worry about it.
You're a good, strong, uncommonly powerful man, dedicated to his country to serve the United States. That man, the President of the United States. A man who can bring a historic change to our country. Not as a Democrat, not a Republican, nor independent, but as a Teletubby. That man, Robert David Emanuel Silverstein.
Teletubbies aren't real.
You're not real, man.
You suck, Bobby Silverstein.
Look, it's the comedian.
Hi, I'm voting for Bobby Silverstein because he is going to help our children with their education and do good for boys. I'm done.
Nominee Bobby Silverstein helps the community in many ways. He picks up dog poop. He recycles. He even protects dogs. Robert David Emanuel Silverstein. He even has the support of the community.
The only way that we will be to succeed as a nation. Get out of here!
Thank you.
Mr. Beck. No one listens to either of them.
Okay. Speaking of not listening or talking, we are up here to introduce our presenters for Best Pantomime.
This unit was a tough one because no one in this class knows how to shut up. Especially Victor.
Don't forget Grace.
Oh, yeah.
Wait. Pretty loud there, too, Angelina.
Yeah? Well, your mom!
My mom's not nominated. These are the real nominees for Best Pantomime. Here to present the award are one student whose second language is English and Rose.
Really?
I'm Victor, and this is Bella. Don't tell her, but I forgot her name for most of the year.
What?
Nothing. Anyways, we're here to present the Best Team Player Award. Teams, you get to work with people, make new friends, and just all around socialize.
And get on people's nerves, something you do a lot, Victor.
You know, you think about it, this class is like a team. And this class, this team, has come really far, except for Bobby. And we've all grown and improved, except for Bobby. And I haven't even insulted everyone in this class yet. What? I'm serious. There are plenty of people I haven't insulted.
Like
Sarah and Catherine and Sarah?
Actually, come to think of it, you haven't insulted me either.
Oh, I haven't.
Yeah, actually.
Your bar is big.
Oh.
I mean, you could land a plane on that thing. It's like a football stadium. I could see the stands and the players, and one of them just scored a touchdown. Woo! Go!
Okay, we get it. Have a big morning. Yes. Move on.
What's been you so angry?
I'm on my last nerve with these freshmen.
What do you mean? The freshmen are a delight. Like Grace.
Anyways, the nominees for the Best Team Player are... Victor.
Fish. What's my line?
You're always forgetting your lines in every single project. You're not a very good team player. But the following nominees are... Ava Tabuto,
Chloe DeCourt,
Sarah Hughes,
and Ayla Tabatu,
and Addison Muller.
And the winner is... Just open it.
Hey. Sarah Hughes!
Sarah, please come and collect your award. Sarah?
Sarah!
Sarah!
I'm not
accept it for her on her behalf and keep going.
Okay, you know, we're just gonna give it to Sarah. Bye!
Here.
talented to work with. Angelina must have written that. Now, I know how Tori feels, hosting her gig for period 9.
Oh.
Let's just move on to the award Victor so desperately uses to justify pretending to be a psychopath.
Hello, everyone! Yes, Chris and I are presenting Best Villain Award. The most sinful of all of them all.
Speaking of sin, do you like my shirt? Hashtag endowed.
No. Forget that. Just put this on.
Oh my god, I love it. Where'd you get it?
Zach gave it to me. Just do it. Race.
What?
The nominees?
Oh yeah, and now it's time to endow the nominees for Best Villain. And the nominees are Victor Dreher, Valentina Lip, Rose Moyes, Tori Mora. And the winner is...
Hang on.
Lydia Finger.
Victor Dreher!
She drank all the soda.
Oh, right. And my friend who hurts himself We're on stage. Get up, Olivia! Get up!
I'd rather not, you know, it's kind of comfy down here. I got body slammed for Satan's sake.
Oh my god.
You know.
Yeah.
It's not fun playing a sinister sister.
It is not. We're here to present the Lip Sync Award, where you pretend you are talented.
Do you think mine and Addison's would win? I did play a good Connor Murphy.
No, it was so bad.
Wait,
the Lip Sync Award is for people who can't really sing, so maybe you would.
Dear Evan Hansen.
No! Stop! Shut up! You're so annoying!
Anyways, Mr. Beck made a bad decision putting us together.
Yeah.
Anyways, the nominees. Cheerleaders, Hamilton, Where Have All the Children Gone, and The Road to El Dorado. The winner is...
Oh. You're not doing a good job at this.
No, I'm not. Kindergartner. The winner is Cheerleaders.
$16.60. Nice to see you again.
Yes, I downloaded this app called Catch.com.
Improvising is something anyone can do, but these four students go above and beyond the Academy Award.
And the nominees for the best improvisers are
Chloe D,
J.H.,
Zach R.,
and last but not least, Alexa N.
Oh, that's my card. Wait a second.
Why do they make the tape so tight?
Improvise or something. I'm not good at improvising. I wasn't nominated. Sorry, trees. And the winner is Zach R.
Nominees are Abigail A, Annie C, Ethan L, and Rose M.
And the winner is Rose M.
No, I'm kidding. no. I love KFC.
Or do I?
What are you doing, Annie? Are you scaring the freshmen again?
No.
No, come on.
No. No.
Hey, now that is officially awkward. Time to introduce someone who scares freshmen more than I do. And Sid.
Oh,
wait. He's not here. He left us to play a wicker sham in Susan.
Excuse me.
Yeah, y'all don't like it in here. That was going on.
Is it time for the best freshman in the front row to step over?
For once, Kaylin, I think you're right.
You're a little bit.
Maybe. We had to save the show from whatever boring thing you were saying.
I'm not boring.
Whatever, disco ball.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Allison Priestley. I hope you're enjoying the showcase so far. We are here to announce the MVP award. MVP stands for Most Valuable Player. This recipient of this award is someone who showed their hard work and dedication to our class. The nominees are Grace Curcio, Chloe DeCourt, Sarah Hughes, and Bobby Silverstein. Yeah. Awesome. Let's say it together. The nominees are Grace Curcio.
I said that, Allison.
Sorry, my dad. <mom. laughs> Okay, and the winner is Chloe DeCourt!
Both of
we fished it better, so you can really taste it. And then I just fried it until golden brown.
That sounds amazing.
That sounds really good. And you're using the multi-purpose seasoning?
Yes. Its purpose is to give bland food a nice little kick to it.
Sounds really good. And it's starting to smell really good too. Can't wait to try it.
Oh my goodness.
This is so good! It just melts in your mouth!
The flavor is so delectable and delightful. Thank you.
I'm glad you guys enjoy it. The key to good food is love, dedication, and plus unseasoned.
How come hers is so good when we use the exact same seasoning? I'll be the real judge here.
Yeah, go ahead.
It's kind of spicy. Be careful.
Yeah!
the common.
Thank you.
Thank you. of the 5th Annual Beckie Awards. My name is Aiden Kelly.
And my name is John Doty, and we are officially old.
Yeah.
That being said, Mr. Beck asked that we could sprinkle onto you all a little bit of our experiences as musical theater majors who have gone through the theater program at Farmingdale and how it helped us transition into our future education at Rider University.
Mr. Beck's Theater 2 class taught us many things, but one of the most important aspects about the course was how it prepared us for the college audition process. The horrid, grueling, vicious, and terrifying college audition process. Thanks to Mr. Beck's knowledge of the craft, the once terribly frightening audition process became an experience that didn't strike fear into our hearts, but made us aware how we could learn and grow as performing artists.
One of the most beneficial things that helped me personally was the making of a resume. Mr. Beck helped all of us format the resumes correctly and even gave us tips on what we should and should not add. I was a senior when I took the class, so it was very beneficial making the resume when I was going into college auditions. Hey, Mr. Beck, did you know that I could burp the ABCs on command? Fun fact, I added that to my resume, and it's still there to this day.
And one of my biggest takeaways was by far making sure that you were giving the most authentic and genuine performance that you could. Mr. Beck and I worked a lot on actually experiencing the emotions a character is feeling while performing in the scene. If my character was overjoyed, angry, sad, or whatnot during my scene, I made sure I was too, keeping in mind to recall these emotions in a healthy manner. After all, no audience member is going to truly believe in your performance unless you truly believe in it yourself.
While Aiden and I both went through the same process, they did look a little different.
That's right, all of my auditions were virtual,
and all of mine were in person. We'd like to thank Mr. Beck for being so versatile and that we were both able to succeed despite Aiden getting special treatment because his year looked a little different than mine.
Well, I only got special treatment because I was his favorite.
That's funny because actually I was.
No, I'm pretty sure I was.
No, I think you're wrong because I'm pretty sure I was his favorite, John. I'm pretty sure I was his favorite. Taught us stage combat too.
But the by far most important thing that we learned from Mr. Beck was
don't hand things in the day before they're needed.
I mean, it's the funniest thing!
It's
hilarious!
That's the best!
What's going on, guys?
You know, Ryder? I didn't know Ryder University was on Long Island.
Woo! Go Frogs! Come to Ryder!
Yeah!
Woo!
Thank you for coming. I'll be together. grades are so bad. You have an F in gym. Who gets an F in gym? Your grades have never been below a B. You need to get your grades up, Tron.
Sorry, Mom.
Sorry doesn't cut it. You know what? I'm taking your call.
What? No, that's
no, I'm keeping it until your grades are up.
But Mom.
No, Sean.
$1 million ticket on the side of the street, win $1 million, and then get kidnapped by Kevlunkian drug lords,
and then be held for ransom, and then go on Oprah and tell the entire world the story, and it would still be the most boring, yawn-inducing story I have ever heard.
That's so mean.
Well, it's the truth. I only let you tell the story because we were friends, and then we're not friends anymore. You can't tell the story.
Fine.
Well, then, you can't tell the Lake Mead story.
What sense does that make?
If I can't tell the Joey Feinberg story, you can't tell the Lake Mead story. But the Joey Feinberg story happened between me and Joey Feinberg.
And the Lake Mead story happens both you and me.
It's 50% mine,
my rights.
And I don't want you telling it.
But 50% of mine,
too. You can tell your 50% of it.
This is ridiculous.
I'm serious. Don't talk about anything that's involving me. Leave me out of everything.
Fine.
You can't tell anybody that I told you about that panel.
Okay.
Promise me.
I promise you.
I'm writing it down. See?
You can't tell anybody about the time that I got my period at the softball game.
I thought we knew that.
Everybody thinks it was Jackie.
Nuh-uh.
Why do you think they call her Jackie Swabinson?
Ew. Gross. That's awful.
Whatever. It's payback time. She told everybody I had mono when I did at that time.
I guess.
Well, you guessed right.
She's a hoe. Did you know she didn't tell Marty after she knew I liked him?
Well, because she's like that, and I told you not to tell her that. But for the record, I can date Tommy now!
What?
Well, once we sign this, all's fair.
Fine, does that mean I can date Adam then?
Yeah, sure, whatever. I don't care!
You can tell anybody that I'm seeing a therapist.
You kissed Rachel Bob!
Oh my god, I told you?
No!
Oh my god, I can't believe I just told you that.
So what happened?
Oh my god, she's
helpful.
Hi, I'm Bella.
Hi, I'm Ava.
And we're and the second award of the evening is the Best Parody Award.
Lifetime movies.
Movies? I love movies!
Hey!
Hey, how you doing?
Hi, Jared.
Hi,
hey.
Dad.
Hi.
Shoes.
Your shoes.
Oh, thank you!
Wait, shut up!
Sorry.
Anyway, the nominees for our Best Parody Award are...
Thanks for the Holidays.
Six Night of Sadness.
Oh!
And the waitress fine.
And the winner is.
Don't listen to them.
Six Night of Sadness!
Very slow.
my ex.
Hey, come on, chat.
Yeah.
Hey, get away!
Whoa, whoa. Hey. All you do is break hearts and ask the bee's knees.
Hey, wait. Don't you go pull back. Bee's knees in my bum.
Ow.
Mona, what happened to the lilacs?
Hey, y'all.
Punched in the face.
Punched in the face? You mean what Mr. Beck wants to do to all of us this week because
because no one is prepared?
Yeah, Griffin prepared more for his full scene, and that's not saying much.
You know, Russia, so excited to teach in Moscow. Is that like it?
No, we've been working on this for a week.
Okay, it's not my fault. Griffin, shut up, leave.
Bye.
Yeah, like that. The next scene was supposed to be Beckies. It was a dark comedy.
Just like our lives.
Hysterically out of control and deeply tragic.
Just like our lives.
And lack of a father figure.
Just like our lives!
Yeah, I wonder why Beckies would pick us for this scene. Well, since we're not performing this due to lack of preparation, I'm thinking we need a theme. We need a new transition.
No, 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 no. You mean transformation, because we're going to present that award next.
Champion is
You know, I'm just like a little offended that neither of us got nominated for the best transformation.
Yeah, same.
I mean, you went from a little redheaded Catholic girl to an emo, whatever this is.
And you went from abled to disabled, and then abled again.
Yeah, really, I was like a whole transformer with my metal hip brace for a month and crutches for 5 months.
Yeah, it was like you were cosplaying Crutchy from Newsies for 5 whole months.
Okay, we have established that my hip hasn't been my best feature this year. But we have an award to present.
Oh yeah, I thought we were just fighting again.
Okay, the nominees are JT and Emily,
Isabella Winter, Ava G, and Bella McDonald. And the winner is...
We're supposed to move on to the next award.
idea.
Big city hot class stop.
I know we didn't do the redneck scene, and you guys did slight. You can get out of character now.
This girl's crazy. She's crazier than a big and mating season.
Okay, sure, get off stage. Goodbye.
Four people at once, I'm mentally ill.
Anyway, back up in Pride Month, nonetheless, is honestly just ridiculous. I shouldn't have to stand for this. The gay struggle is something many of you can relate to. And I just feel like this is a little ridiculous that there's like a whole month. Why can't it be the whole year? So, my plan. The straight people of theater. No longer! You have until June! The end of June marks your reckoning! I hope I make myself clear to all of you.
Nope.
What do you mean no? Who said no?
Bobby!
Bobby! You know who that is! That's the
stop now.
Yeah, we kind of have to get back to the scene.
Are they ready? Hope so. Good luck.
On the tree eve in the cold state of Colorado, a grumpy businesswoman named Abigail visits her hometown for Hanukkah. I hate Hanukkah. The only reason I came back to the stupid small town was to tell my parents that I'm done funding their family business on making personalized menorahs. It just reminds me too much of my old six-candle flame.
Jared, I'm sorry, Abigail, but you are so late.
What? On the sixth night of Hanukkah? How can you do this to me?
I'm sorry, but I, Hanukkah, can't.
Hanukkah will never be the same ever again. Thanks a lot, Jared. Abigail finally arrives at the house of her parents, Minty and Spearminterson. Building up the confidence to tell them about their family's small business making customized menorahs, she can't help but feel guilty for being away for too long.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Long time no see. Hi, dear. It's been so long since you visited home. You never call or text anymore.
What's it like living up in a big city?
Oh, no. Yeah, it's been good. How are you guys? How's the business?
Great. Now that you're here, how's Jared?
Dad! No, me and Jared broke up 5 years ago, right before I left this town.
I'm so sorry, honey. You know, we just love you two together. What if you, Jared?
Mom! I know what you're gonna say, and the answer is no. Let's just get to what I actually came here for. I don't know how to say this, but I'm done funding your business.
What? As a business executive, if you stop funding our Etsy shop for making personalized menorahs, it'll go out of business.
I'm sorry, Dad. This holiday just brings back too many bad memories.
Upon return, she reconciles with her old friends, Jesus Cristiano and Grace Maria McJoy.
Adios, mio. Abigail, is that you?
Shut up. It's been so long since you visited home.
I know, it really has. How have you guys been? How is this town?
Hi, husband. So good lately. I've been loving morning mass. So excited. This tiny town just hasn't been the same since you went away for your super successful business, Stacy.
How about you, Bessie?
I'm doing okay. I wanted to talk to my parents about their family business. Because if I don't fund it, it's gonna go, well, out of business. I don't care about it, though. It brings back too many bad memories.
Like what bad memories?
Ugh, when me and Jared broke up on the sixth night of Hanukkah?
O.M. Jesus. Don't.
And now,
please, don't be
staring at me. He worked at the cafe that I happened to stroll into? Out of all places?
Never mind that. Look, he's coming over here.
Abigail, is that you?
You look great.
Jared, you look great.
So, I mean, how have you been?
What's new with you?
Good. I mean, I'm in the city.
I have to go walk my, holy water.
You two look like you have a great time catching up.
Yeah.
Adios, mio. Are you that little
The previous lovers take their conversation to a quaint gazebo, sheltering from the frigid snow.
I didn't know you were a barista. How's it been?
Oh, it's all right. I mean,
hasn't been the same without you here. How's the family business?
Well, I don't know.
Well, I mean,
I do know. I'm quitting.
What? That was your dream. It was what you wanted to do.
No, it's not. It's just... never mind.
Wait. You left because we... I remember! Oh, it was just the third night of Hanukkah. We broke up, right?
It was the sixth night of Hanukkah! It was a cold winter eve on the sixth night of Hanukkah, and you left me here under this gazebo, cracking my brains out. You left me here for no reason, no explanation, and no warning!
Abigail, wait!
Let her go, Sharon.
Wait. Where did you guys come from? Were you watching us?
You're always watching.
Do you think she'll come around?
I'll subscribe. I'll be head to
what you want to do.
Alright, I'm gonna go get her.
Best actor, and Terry Lynn with a little bit of fighting in order to present Best Actress.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
I'm Aiden.
Hi.
I'm John. So, me and John are here to present the Best Actor Award. And Terry Lynn?
I'm here to present Best Actress.
Okay, the nominees for Best Actor are JT, Griffin, Shay, and Bobby.
And it wasn't because I came here yesterday and found out I wasn't presenting, and through my amazing, not dramatic, hissy fit. Even though I was not able to see all the theater students progress this year, I'm so thankful that you guys have joined theater and have carried on the legacy. The nominees for Best Actress are Emma, Sarah, Ava Leno, Alexa, and Gabby Pace. And also, I'm very worried for these students because this whole time you guys have been ripping it when you can just simply slide it out. Anyway, the award for Best Actress is Emma.
Thank you.
Everyone, quiet down.
Oh, hi, Mr. Beck, you're here.
Sorry I was late. My Kia Soul broke down. Anyway, as with our project-based learning, actually, I just didn't make a lesson plan. So you guys will have to write something for the Beckies because we all know we can't clean the costume closet again.
Love cleaning rat poop again.
And no more silverfish, please.
Why'd I give a professional acting for this? Anyway, we need someone to type our notes.
Is this for a grade?
Right! You get a 98.764.
Really?
Check the rubric. All right. Let's take attendance. Catherine?
Here, only half of the time.
Luke? Here! Woo! I appreciate your enthusiasm. Jordan?
Here.
No, Jordan R. Oh, Jordan, looking at Schoology, it appears you owe me work from Peter 1, 2, 3, and 4.
I actually needed to argue with you about my grade on that one project.
What project? You didn't do any work or turn anything in. In fact, you were on a cruise.
Still, my lawyer-like personality indicates that I deserve a 100.
Jordan H.
Loud snore.
Joey?
Oh! Joey!
I'm imaginary!
All 4 years.
Really?
Simon? Simon! Simon!
Joey's alone already!
Alright! Ugh. Jenna.
Here! Oh my gosh, Mr. Beck, I love your sweater.
What would I do without this charming yet annoying student?
Flashback!
Everyone, this is Jenna. She's a junior. She'll be joining our class this year.
Mr. Beck, can you tell me everybody's names and pronouns?
No! Let's go play with matches!
Yay! Matches!
Let's go make a mushroom room! Not affiliated with drugs.
Flashback!
Simon late as usual.
So, speaking of relationships and talking to this new boy.
No one cares about your relationships or where your obsession with boys started. Flashback! John, theater alumni John Doty, cast in every single lead role. What are you doing here? Guys, we have to get Alice done! We have 3 days left!
Oh, the sex
You did the best you could under the conditions of a pandemic. I often ask myself that. But the skills you've learned, like collaboration, problem solving, and communication, will help you in any career.
Even in STEM.
Contrary to popular opinion, you've learned important life skills that will help you succeed in any career.
I hate this! I hate everyone!
I always say I hate everything, but that's right. And I actually like theater.
You all suck!
Anyway, remember when I was robbed of Best Villain?
No, I don't
remember. Flashback.
And the winner to the 2019 Beckies for Best Villain goes to... Not Simon!
No! How many of my classmates do I have to kill to get this award?
Flashback over.
Today we are being observed, so we'll be taking a break from writing the Becky script.
I'm so excited to see this wholesome class.
We're playing the alphabet game. Simon, start with the letter A.
Hey, aren't you gonna yell at me for giving my best friend my car keys?
You're out!
No!
Cord, and then there are some seniors who came to us late that didn't get all four, but I want them to obviously come up and light the candle with us. So I'm also stalling for time because some of them have to change. All right. So I'll start actually by calling up the seniors who probably are not changing right now. So we'll start with the seniors who joined us late in the game, but we love them just as much. So I'm gonna say Emma, come on up. Emma's going to Ryder for acting, so she's continuing the theater tradition. We have Sarah Hughes. Cheerleader in that routine. She used to be a cheerleader, and then she found theater, and we stole it. So she joined us.
And then we have, probably Wendy's going to come from the back. Wendy! Individual. She's become quite the fashionista, and she doesn't care. She'll wear Christmas outfits in May, and everybody, she's just awesome that way. Emily Cohen. Our resident artist. So she wasn't kidding. She painted an entire throne in like 2 days, and yes, the fumes did get to her. So that was accurate. Joey, Mr. Imagine. Imaginary. Maybe the last 3 years, but this year, Joey, you really come into your own, and we're so proud of you. You've become quite, I mean, we saw in the scene, much, you're able to speak, advocate for yourself, so awesome. My spicy chicken nugget, Olivia Terry. She may be small, but she's feisty, folks. She has always been willing to volunteer and help and do whatever she can to make the program better, so I appreciate that. Megan Dreher. Yeah! Anytime there was a project, the class looked at her, she's like, fine, I'll do it. But she has been more than that. She has come so much so far in her acting and her ability. She's going to be such a world traveler, and she's going to educate us all in the history of the world. We will miss her very much. Mini-Me! Didn't really say much, but again, if we go by Wendley's, he also was in English class, and I bullied him or tried to get him to take it.
I think we were in the same class. Yes. Yeah. He was a bully.
Probably, in my opinion, the best thing he could have ever done. He has grown as a very assertive, strong, talented young man who I couldn't be prouder of. Personality is for sure. She is very smart, even if she doesn't turn in her work all the time. But I really think when she applies herself, she really has a strength of character that I think she could do well with in the future. And you should look at law school for sure. Hey, Simon! So, our tatted, colored hair, always late, Simon. But Simon, again, same thing. If you knew Simon early in his high school career, it was very different than where Simon is now. Simon has always wanted to crack a joke, to analyze everyone's personality, and really, when Simon's involved, things are always a lot of fun. So thank you, Simon, for the 4 years. And last but not least, Catherine. Stage manager who will be leaving us, and that will leave a big hole in the Playcrafters program. But beyond that, Catherine has really stepped up whenever anything was needed. So the scene in which she was like, I gotta do the lights, anybody would call her and be like, Catherine, we need help with the lights, and she would run with her pack of Monster and be able to do all the lights. But beyond that, she is a very strong, powerful young lady who Disney would be very honored to have you working for them. What I want to do, we only do one because it's not a Sweet 16. So what we're going to do is see if we can all kind of get around the table. Ladies, join us. Alright, so maybe make a level. Loop direct them.
Level.
Make level.
So what's a level?
What do you mean, level?
So like, someone's here, yeah.
Everybody comes up.
So cover the floor.
Everybody comes up, you can't see.
All right, I'll go down. I'll go down.
Move! Move! Move!
Move! Move! Move! Move! Move! Move! Move! Move! So we're all gonna, So I'm actually gonna give it to you. Just put your spirit in. She can't do it. This is what class is like every day. It's a safety liner. It's for children. All right, Joey.
Yes!
Keep supporting us. We appreciate you all. See you next year.